Hello guys and welcome to another World of Tanks video here, Mr. Forecast. So subscriber spotlight number 7 coming right up, but first just show you on screen there my email address. You can send the replay to me and but please upload what replays.com your replay there. Log in easily there with your World of Tanks account and upload your replay and then just copy the link to your replay and send it to me in the email you see on screen. So then I can easily download the replay from that site, and also most importantly, I can see the battle result and also record the battle result from that site if I use your replay. Jeg prøvde før higher tier, medium battles, tier 8 og tier 10. It's very hammer fun, and usually it's where the fun battles are to be seen also. Well, I guess someone likes heavies and tanks for us best anyway, but oh well, can't be helped, can't be helped. Also, just point out that I only run the latest World of Tanks client, so currently at patch 9.2, and 9.3 test server is up now, and we are closing in on patch 9.3 with some reworked maps here and there. So beware that you don't send me an older replay where the map has already been reworked on the current patch. Then I will have a problem running the replay, and then I can't use it at all. So yeah. Anyway, let's get going. Subscriber spotlight 7 for more battles coming in. I hope you have fun watching. So, Arctic region. Hello to Matto 97 in his object from 40. Looking good there with his stats.
Let's go.
Arctic region standard, and we got typical tier 10 battle. Death Star, Jagdpanzer E4, SDB1, M48 Patton, S4, IS7 platoon, AMX 50 on 20. In platoon also, T92 actually in platoon with the heavy tanks there. Then we can most likely consider that artillery will be focused on the corner down there on the southeast side, helping out this platoon for this. So we've got 40. Would maybe try and push in here now. I haven't seen this battle before now. Rain is going straight in. A very, very difficult maneuver that on Arctic region these days. Often you're being spotted up here and you're being shot from over here. As you can see now, he's nearly dead already. They're taking a lot of shots there. My Leopard PTA does what I would have done. In the object from 40 here. Get myself over there. The object from 40 is strong in that position with minus 6 gun depression and low profile and bouncy turret. Takes a hit for Centurion, who's most likely sits behind the roof on the side of the rock there. Little Rain died horribly. Not very surprising. M48 Patton. It's not very bouncy usually, but it can often actually also bounce in the turret around the gun mantlet, and if it hit it a bit on the side, it can easily bounce. But damn, it's such a big target usually. Blind shot there looked like it went straight in. So brave move here, going in. Let's hope he doesn't meet the same fate as the rain. That's turn one, but he's very open to take hits now, and I hear the shots coming in. Ah, can't get the gun down. Ah, here it comes. That was. Yeah, he got set on fire also. a hit from the pattern. Then he's not afraid to get stuck in here. Help out M103. But again, that damn gun repression. Take a big hit. 5120 there. He's occupied by killing the M103 and finish him off, and then also put Centurion 71 coming in here. Ah, you better get stuck in now. Oh, you got the pattern coming down. It's wild. Yeah. Nice lead on there. Then can focus on the pattern. Bit lucky to not bounce there. That was a good angle on the upper plate. Could easily have bounced that. Løve, no problem. Easy target with 264 average penetration. And bounced on the upper plate and quickly track the pattern. Hopefully he don't have a repair here. And finish him off with a bit of help from the Centurion, who is still alive. Nice. Ferdinand got taken out by artillery. Bat shot, 3 kills already. So yeah, Centurion 1 is still alive up there. So nah, don't bother with that. Ah, there you got spotted. And he's low. Ah, oh, he missed. And he got himself into cover. Damn. He's got him spotted. Ah, he shows himself very foolishly there. Got to kill him and him. And they are really attacking down on that corner now. The 215B and the IS-7 still holding up there. But damn, they have the 183 Death Star Jack Panzer. I need to be held down. ISU is going straight in there and takes a hit, but that much must have been HE. Just 600 hit points it took there. Usually those jagpans are rolling with 1000. So they got some health left, especially the IS-7 there. And E-75 also. So he's... I'm going to quickly pause, lagging a bit. So he decided to go around there, mostly the voice... most... I guess it's best choice. So... 2 versus 5. Damn. 4008 damage down. And Batcha took some... line shots. And damn, it's tricky to pan this guy. Need to have his lower plate. That's better, and he bounced also. Oh, get that gun down. Damn, need to hit this guy so many times. I'm going to take a hit now. He's nearly reloaded. Oh, thankfully artillery bounced. Missed him in. Nearly got the IS-7. Yeah. Good one, and he didn't take a hit from IS-7 either. Damn. Well, at least I got him tracked. You should stop now and aim for the hatch, yeah. But still, damn, E-75 got them. I'm actually going to check. That was straight in the roof there. Damn. Unlucky. Not to bounce that. Oh, I got the Death Star coming in. No. Penetration. Oh, use the corpse as cover. No. Ah, anyway. He was so low we could finish him off there. And just him left now. So IS-4. You need at least 2 shots on IS-4 to kill him. And that's a tricky bastard to penetrate often also. But he really needs to get artillery. Get artillery and then he have some options to get in. Nah, he has to go back and try and reset the cap, I guess. T-92 is also one of those with a lot of health, at least 500 hit points. So he would need 2 shots to get the T-92 and then most likely spend too much time doing that. The right thing here is to go back, especially considering now that they are 2 capping. So he really has to haul ass, as they say now, to be able to make this. And it's not looking good. A bit sad that this IS-4 especially is happy to cap this. The object is very low health here. Ah, oh, come on you cowards. Finish me off. No, damn it. And it's a defeat. Yeah, try desperately to get a shot in there. Oh well, can't win them all. So, into the battle result, and sadly that was a defeat. But damn, Master Badge Ace Tanker on a defeat in a tier 10, object on 40, that's not bad at all. I don't often see that. Damn. So, hi Kelber, and Top Gun 1920, and over 100,000 credits received there. So, got a lot of ammunition and also repair, so 31,000 profit, 1,920 experience, very nice, 777 assisting, 1,040 block by armor, 7,299 damage done, but got the top gun, but not enough there to win it. Can't carry that much, damn. So a very good game there by Matto97. And he sure got this damage in and many kills, but still, damn fail team. Damn you all. Anyway, fun to watch there on Arctic Region in his object from 40, Matto97. Thank you for sending the replay. Himmelsdorf with a Leopard 1 standard battle, and we got Chacharo again with his platoon mate Sir Retro in his bat chat. So your typical tier 10 battle here, E100, 215 BMO, C5, T57 heavy. It's a good mix up here. Jagdpanzer E4, Wuffel, and damn it, we got them all, but no artillery. That's a bit sad, but I always like to see artillery on this map, because I know they hate it. more artillery, the better than him stuff. Slow that. So he's not going on the hill. Hello, Betty boy! May I shoot you? Thank you. May I shoot you again? No. Damn, you're no fun. And we got a little panther, a little light panther over there. You can shoot. No. Wuffel. As you can see, we can shoot straight through cars and everything. Got to love the acceleration, agility, so quick in and out. Hello, and that gun, very accurate gun. It has a bit of a spread though when you rotate your turret and move about, but it's not that bad. Ah, that was a bad shot. No chance of penetrating there. Take a blind one. No, my bad chat is back for more. Maybe. No. He got his platoon mate up on a hill, I see now. I haven't paid attention to the minimap at all. And they are rolling in on that corridor. It's a good position down here actually to get the shots up on the hill when they come in on the side. Got D5, new. Nothing there to hit. Here they come. Of course, we have to just do a critical there. New. Aim on top. On top, top, top. There we go. But bit bad angle there. Can easily bounce that weak spot. Mouse, that's the place to hit them. Straight on. But no, it's rather difficult. And premium for win. Damn it, he has to defend himself, so. Yay! Ah, oh, nice! Saved his platoon buddy there from taking damage. Oh, could have shot his upper plate there because he dipped down, so he had the correct angle for that, most likely. .330 average penetration with the premium rounds. Spamming the that premium. Ah, even 100 swerves around them. Misses his shot there. Oh, I should have gone around the corner. Oh well, the even under was it. Reloading anyway. D75, damn, it's hectic here now. And we are running premium still. Able there to pan the side of turret. Was a rather extreme angle, but I guess he would maybe have bounced there with ordinary shells. But you have very good average penetration with ordinary shells also. 268 average penetration. Hello! See how quick. Back and forth. So quick to reverse into cover again. Too big angle there. Quickly repair track and get into cover. Just get that damn lure out of the way. Yeah. Oh, thankfully. He missed. There you go. That's better. Ah, good one. There you have that good average penetration of the normal shells. Could have easily bounced there with some other medium tanks with lower average penetration. Oh, looked nearly like it would hit us there. So then, just D5 left there. Damn it. Nearly 7,000 damage. And his platoon mate is still alive. You haven't taken much damage either. Good one. He's distracting the E5. We're able here to shoot his side. And very nice shot there to track him. Keep him from going after his platoon mate. Ah!
We've lost
I'm lucky there, but no problem, he could take a couple of hits here. And now we got help also. Two guys up on the hill and also the E5. Bye bye! And good night. Very, very nice game there in the Leopard one. 7,007 something damage. And 3 kills each there. Got to love that. So that means Brother Snobs, High Caliber, and Confederate. And also we got the nice shiny Mastery Badge Ace Tanker there. 105,000 credits received, 2005-21, but some mission thing there, so 2017 experience with premium, so very nice for a tier 10 medium. 16,594 profit, even though we spent a lot there on ammunition, and used some consumables also, which is not listed. Maybe I had them already in depot. I know that I had many of those because we've been winning them in several rewards earlier. So most likely why he used them there, I guess. It's rather expensive to run with those premium things. 7,776 damage done and 7 hits received. 320 blocked by armor and damage 10, 3 kills and 1144 assisting damage. So good game there, and his body there also, nearly 5000 damage. So we had a good one also with 3 kills. So damn, that's a lot of damage in between them, 6 kills. And yeah. Very, very nice to show. Spamming a bit premium though. But oh well, can't be helped. Can understand why you wanted to use them. So good game on Himmelsdorf in the Leopard 1. So find yourself on minimap up, please. Malovka, and it's 10:46 button time, we love you. K-Mash, platooned up with Dr. Baikos something. So, a good player here, as you can see. Nice stats. So, a good win chance here also. So, encounter. I'm going to fight some Tifid Force maybe here, up on the hill. E75, I8. So yeah, always fun to see the pattern in action. Got a good hit there. We have rather poor accuracy, but the gun is really reliable, even though it has really poor accuracy, 0.4. Nice side shot there, and already 1140 damage done. Damn it. Keep it fall down there. Blind shot. KB1S. Wait for it. Ah, no, 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 no. You failed me, gun. So we're with 430 version 2. His platoon mate there. Yeah, he's gone down in the middle of the north side. So, got some shots coming in, and also hope artillery is not zoomed in here. I provide a smoke screen for him here, so artillery can't hit him. I still being spotted, and some tanks down there who wants to shoot up here. Just looking, see if I can spot anyone. No. Damn, T4 just got himself down there and is attacking a T69 at the moment. That's bad news for the T69. Also, got a heavy tank coming down there. I see on the minimap now. So as always, I haven't seen this battle before now. I know the battle result screen, but have no clue how this plays out. So YS3 don't really have a bouncy turret here, so I don't usually like to do this too much with the pattern. It's so easy to get up there and have the accuracy fail you, and then being just panned straight in top of the turret all the time. It's so frustrating. Anyway, have the mobility, good acceleration in and out, and that's great fun with the pattern. Oh, thank you, E75, you're so kind. Displaying all your side there. And nice one. Got the T54E1. And T54s there are not very afraid of these guys, so rushing into them. So he's freed up here to just snipe and get shots in. Come on, nah. Russian drunk armor. Typical. The artillery turned blue there. Sturro Emil, or what you call him. He's a soft target, not much armor on those guys. Insane gun depression on them, as far as I remember. And close one. Nearly had a shot there. Not looking very good here. 6-9. Oh, there we got that guy again. And the Black Prince got in the way. So we bounced him instead of hitting the Sturro Emil. Maybe got a blind shot in there. So it's going in here. Artillery gets a second kill. That's good. 8-10 at the moment. Ah, found a prototype. But have many guns pointing his way now. And bad shot there, took just his track, thankfully. And they are capping! 3 minutes! Need to provide more smoke screen here. Or he's gonna fail, I'm sure of it. E75 is coming down behind him. Maybe he can use his armor and actually scout a bit here. No, not much for target there. Ah, got Sturro Emil again. He is using his gun depression to poke out up over the ridge line there. Going in for the T28 now. We need a good roll here. Come on. No, of course not. And got his engine damage also. Yay. Brilliant. Auto aim for win. And bang your dad. 3 kills, 4001 damage. Come on, But damn, we have artillery in game here. Ah! Thank you. 4 kills.
We've lost a track.
Ouch! Just about to pause that because it's starting to lag. And that's typical of a replays after a while. It starts to do that. And bit lucky to survive there. But also not so lucky to be hit by that damn back there. So artillery on our side is doing a good job also. With 3 kills. And he got the Black Prince. So T-54 got artillery. So now it's K-Mash and the E-75 left here. E-75 has good health, so hopefully he should make this. But most likely need 2 hits into that artillery, and he is most likely reloaded and ready. We have a damaged engine here. But this is dangerous. Ah, is he actually going to drown himself now? Damn. 2-2 here. You got a T-54 still on your team. What are you thinking? If he sat here now, aiming dead on, he could have taken it out. But instead he sits there in the barn. Pond. Is that what they call it in English? On the seaside. I don't know. T-54. He was over there killing our artillery. And has maybe gone up the hill. Would be, well, maybe he's coming in here. Would be surprised if he came in and out on the open there, but not the most skilled guy, so anything is possible. That's the thing with these guys that are not so skilled. You have no clue what they are going to do next. They could do the most stupid things and all the times do the good things. So yeah, bit of a waiting game here. He can't really take too many hits, and E-54 is a rather fast firing medium tank with 320 average damage, and he has 333 HP left here. You could easily be one shot by the T-54 if the T-54 rolls over his average. E-75 is going in. Was a cap at least. Ah, that will not work with a broken engine. So he's going for a safe option here and not travel up there. Could be that T-54 is up here somewhere. Wouldn't surprise if he's coming down here soon. As he has currently on the hill, and now that he says for his capping, he's forced to come down. Let's see. Or maybe he's just waiting around here, trying to survive. That's my 2 best guesses, at least, at the moment. Ah, he was sitting there. But you know, that's for sure. I'm gonna zoom out so we can see if you're taking any shots to E-75. The E-75 is a bit hull down there. Wait, they go round, he says. In chat there, K-Mash. Yeah, We had them there now. Most likely, maybe he's going to be spotted there. Be careful. Yeah, he's 75. We've got a nice position. Stay held on, he says to him in chat. But you never know with the T-54. Can spam those heat rounds with over 300 average penetration and then could possibly pan the E75 in the turret. But also you have that weak spot on top the hatch. Ah, nice one. Good shot there by the E75. So 4827 damage done there. But let's head on over to the battle result. K-Mash! Malovka encounter, precious ace badge, and high caliber, and confederate. Lot of credits there. 2013 experience with premium, and additional reward, mission, action payouts, something. And 26,400 profit, not bad. And 1,004 assisting. We split the two. Damage 11 and the 5 kills, 5672 damage done. Took four hits and as often with the pattern and nothing blocked by armor there. It's rather unusual to bounce too much with the M46. So 19 penetrations, overall a very nice game. And this platoon of body there didn't have the best battle. But K-Mashy stepped up and carried it in with a bit of help with from the E75 there. So that was fun to watch someone local. Good game. So, find ourselves on Karelia. And we got Undead. AK1 and that okay, I'm gonna call him on that in his bad chat on Karelia, and this assault battle, and as you can see he has a mark of excellent, he's very excellent. So Batty boy, looking good there, Batty boy. The sunset shining on you. So assault, this is a mode that I don't play. Don't like it too much. Anyway, into his camera, and he's very busy watching the hills here for incoming Smurfs. So yeah, let's see what he does. So the objective here is to attack the enemy base over there on the northwest side and get that base or kill all enemy tanks. And the objective for the enemy is basically to secure base and hold off and not letting them cap or destroy undead team here. Yeah, what are you doing now? Just messing about here. So IS-8. I'm not sure what happened to him. Did he drown himself or something? Anyway, there was had 120 spotted, T-54 spotted. As you can see, a typical tier 10 battle here. With a very skilled Waffen-Traeger. And IS-8. And you have to be very, very careful here. Many, many enemies sitting around there ready to snipe up. We got a lot of action going on the northeast corner. Able to shoot the T4 here and not receiving any hits either. So happy days there. He got killed by the Jag Tiger and it's reloading time. That was 4 hits, 1626 damage done. 3 artilleries there, so best to be in cover from them. All of them tier 9s. T30 is going for it. And Dad is deciding to go in also. Perfectly timed with his reload. Very nice. And a couple of hits more in. 3 shells left there. Not going for reload. Waffle got spotted up there. And there are many tanks on the other corner, so try and get in now. Ah! We got the bad chat! And he burned it off, yay! That's a good arty. And 50B, oh, better get into cover again. And we got another artillery, but we got a low waffle to kill. Very nice. 2 kills and 3004 damage done. Reversing back in there, see if you could spot again. Had that 50B up there. And what are you doing? I'm going to quickly pause it. Lagging. Nearly reloaded. 50B up for the grabs. Go, go! Nice, very nice shooting here, taking his time, but of course we have to make it critical. Bye bye! 3 kills, 4760, and let's watch that sunset while he reloads. Excuse me. So, Batchat spotted over there. Dobbs had 111. Damn, I've been smoking too much today. Been sitting here streaming. Hopefully, got that out of my system. So let's attack the Batchat. Bam! Bam! he's reloading also by the looks of it. Oh, takes a hit there from left B1. No problem, and quickly reloads. Quickly starts to reload. Very quick to reload. 38.31 second. 7 shells left, and then 5 premium. 4 kills, 5,735 damage done so far. Already is... had a great battle there. Kill we spotted. Oh, come on, reload already! Yay! Best kill in the game. Oh, we got the load on beside, just finish him off quickly there. And... Oh well. Can't be helped. At least we saw him blow up. Then he reloads. Since he have only a full clip of premium. So instead of reloading into a 4 clip of non-premium, it's better to have a full clip. So it will cost a bit, but what the hell. So, got the top gun, 6485, and most likely now it has to be one, and the VK4502B is coming around on the south side. We're really cleaning up here. Lagging again. Damn replay. Oh, it's such a beautiful world. Dun, dun, dun. Go, go, and dad. AK1. Ah! Crazy! Has to be one. VK full health. Two. Need to hit three. Oh, yes! Able to finish him off with four shots there from full health to nothing. And now in reload mode, and let's just. Yeah. You still alive back there? Power slide into the water. Must be one got a hit into him. Four shells left in total. Nearly reloaded. Bring it, has to be one. Bring it, come on. No, missed. Ah, yes. Oh, I just got the last killing shot in there before the has to be one was able to reload. Damn, has to be one. They actually have a fast reload. That's DPM of all tier 10 medium, so must have been very close. So maybe you got the ammo rack. That's very typical. Being having the ammo wreck damaged with Dust B1, especially when you've been hit in on the side front there. So, really terrible battle here, just 9000 damage and 8 kills. Blah! I do that every time. So, yeah, great battle here, damn it. 9010 damage, 28 hits, and I have just one shell left. Out of the 30 shell that the Batshed can carry. And Radley Walters also with 8 kills there. Great one. That must have been amazingly fun. Looking at the sunset again. Take a screenshot. That's looking good. That's better. Screenshot. So let's head on in and have a look at the battle result. So we're gonna switch over. Where are you? There you are. And as you can see there, I have that on my other monitor here. So victory and ace tanker, very nice. 3060 experience. Radley Walters. High caliber and top gun, and sadly didn't get that last one of the artillery. I would have maybe gotten a Puskusi also, I think. Killed at least two artilleries, didn't he? Anyway, that was 2448 experience, additional 612, so 1632 base experience. That is amazing. That's very, very nice result there. And 88,000 profit, even though we shot some 5 premium shells. And just one shell left. And it took a good deal of damage also. Barely survived. And 2845 assisting, 9010 damage, 27 penetrations out of 29 shots fired. So great game there, damn. That's a carry, that's for sure. Amazing on Karelia with the Batchat, the French tier 10 medium. So very good game there. And that Ek won. So that was fun to watch. So yeah, hope you had fun watching there. That's all I had for this time. Take care on that battlefield, and I hope to catch you next time. Bye for now then.